Good afternoon, everyone. This is just an update on the social hall. Our team of painters just finished applying the second coat of paint to our bleachers, and Cora, one of the leaders of that group, she and her husband have been engaged in this for so long, the lengths, and I just wanted to kind of question how the progress is going, Cora.
I think it's going really well. They look fantastic. They're nice and clean again, and the color matches the walls really well.
That's gravity gray?
It's gravity gray.
How they come up with these names, we don't know.
I don't know, but I think it matches quite well.
But look at the crew there.
Yep, we have a lot
of
help.
The one with all the paint on. Next to him is Jeannie. She's holding the cleaned roller and everything, and Michael, who's lent so much support in a whole array of different projects we've had. In addition to the painting, the two coats that were put on, we have another 20-foot section that a group of gentlemen just brought up from our warehouse down at Sheehan's yesterday evening and then took whatever remained for salvage. And the salvage paid for the rental of the van that we use from U-Haul. So that's all good.
We still have the boards to paint yet that go for the
flooring. Now, what are the plans for the boards? The feet sit on those boards, right?
Yeah, we have to paint those yet. We're going to paint those black. So
they're going to be black?
Yeah.
So you have that 5 gallons of black?
Oh, yes.
That's available.
Yes.
Now, is it difficult to compress the bleachers?
I don't know, Father. We haven't pushed them. We haven't tried.
Okay. Well, so I've just observed that the ones that were brought up yesterday evening currently are compressed and they're bound so they don't spring open. So I think it will be relatively easy. We have a device to do that with.
Good.
And how long of process and what did it entail preparing these bleachers?
Well, we washed them down first because they had cobwebs and stuff spilled on them. We washed them down and then we did the black rail underneath the seat.
So you painted all of the substructure?
Right, and now we did the seats. We painted two coats on the gray.
And do you remember what your dear husband Frank found in there?
Yeah, he found an old penny. I think it was 1952. I think it was a 1952 penny.
He told me 55.
Well, maybe it is 55. I'm not sure.
I think somebody placed it on there to commemorate the installation of these bleachers down at the Redstone facility.
Maybe.
So we're talking 65
years.
Well,
they're quite old. I know they're quite old because I used to sit on these bleachers.
What years were you in Redstone?
I was there until 1966. Frank graduated from Redstone in 1966, and I graduated 67, the first class out of Brownsville when he put them together.
Fantastic. Well, all I can say is we keep moving forward because of the work that you're all doing. I can't express how many individuals who had seen the appliances that we bought at auction and the 40 years of grime and grease that were baked up on it, and you guys cleaned them and beautified them, and they are sparkling stainless steel.
Yep.
And those 3 weeks that we were able to operate our kitchen, they worked
great.
They
yes.
truly did. And so
they did.
We look forward to that
again.
Opportunity again. Hopefully the COVID-19 will ease up and we'll be able to gather as a faith family and keep working on building up our community. So Cora and Jeannie and Tom and Michael, thank you for all of your efforts, and those who are not here like Frank and the others, we truly appreciate it, and we could not be moving forward without your efforts. We had 5 guys yesterday moving all of that scrap metal down to Simiax and bringing up that other set of bleachers. So they worked hard, but we're a team and we're getting her done. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.